In this video, we're going to take a look at using XK01 together with AllThingsTalk. I logged into the AllThingsTalk Maker website here, and I have a playground that I'm going to click into here, and it asked me to connect the device. So let's start with that. Here's a number of different devices, and we decided to use the XinaBox XK01 starter kit. You can click buy, that will take you to our website where you can then get yourself the XK01 kit. If you just click on it, it will now take the definition of this kit and bring it into AllThingsTalk. Up here we have a setting, and here we have the authentication. This device ID and this token you need next. But let's first put it together. So here I have the XK01 kit. So let's put it together here. We're gonna start with taking the CW1 connected to our screen. Let's put that down there. And we're gonna take our SLO1 and our SW1. That, I'm going to take our IP01, MD01, a couple of connectors on top of here. And then we're going to plug in our sensors, a couple more connectors. There we go. We now have our XK01 kit. Let's connect it to power. So here we go with the power plug-in. We then start up XinaBox uploader. And we go in here, it automatically finds your IP01. You just have to go down and choose XK01 AllThingsTalk. And you say flash. While it's flashing here, go over to your AllThingsTalk and click on device ID so you have that copied in. You can go back to the flashing software and wait for that to finish flashing. It then comes up with some questions. The first one is the Wi-Fi network and then the password, which is of course different from user to user. Here we go in and put the device ID in. And then we copy over the token, put that in and say OK. And now it's completed successfully. So let's connect the unit to power again. So we just actually unplugged it and plug it in again to see how it works. So here we got data. We can see the different data coming here. We can go in and look at live, and we can see it have clicked on SSI automatically. So we can go in here and take humidity and temperature, or just take temperature here. And if we go in and choose we want to have a line graph here instead, you can see how the temperature falling. And if I put my finger here on the CW1, we can see how the temperature go up with the heat from my finger here. So let's go a little step further. We go now and we go to another website that's called XinaBox.cc. In this website here, you can build yourself a box or enclosure for your device here. So let's put it together. So we can see here that we have 2 wide and 3 high. And we're gonna go in and make it just a tiny small thinner here so it matches it. So we say first update to that so we get the number so we can see what we are working with. So now that we have us 1, 2, 3 here, you can see number 1, we have the power that goes in here. So we go in and say power USB. Then in number 2, we go in and say we have a sensor grill here, so we kind of like have a little grill over that. And number 3, we have our OLED. And then in number 4, we have our, we down here, we have a logo. So let's put a logo on top of the box. So we put an XinaBox logo here. And then on number 5, we have a sensor, but we have a pretty big sensor, so because there's 2 different sensors. So let's make it sensor full. And then in number 6, we have an LED here for the CW1, so we say LED. And then we have a couple of more things we didn't finish with number 1 down here. We have an LED also there. So we simply go in and say 1 here. And there's also a little power LED, you can see it's blue here. So we say power LED, number 1. And then we decide to have a logo on the back. So we go here, say back logo. And we don't actually have to tell where that is because it takes up the whole back anyhow. So let's look at how that looks like. And here we have the box. So we can see here that we have a window for the OLED. We have a little grill here for the SW1, SLO1 here. We have a logo here, a couple of windows for the LED. And if we look at the back, we have a logo there also. The next thing is we have the box here that we have 3D printed. We can take our kit out, plug it into our box that we made, the logo and all. Plug it in again. There we go.